social media first started, MySpace specifically, everybody got a MySpace account. I was a little slow to the party, kind of pushed against it, but my wife wanted me to get one. Matt got a MySpace, and you know, you go on out and do all this blingy stuff with it.
He bedazzled it.
Yeah. He would put one capital letter, lowercase letter, capital letter, and I'm like, dude, how long did that take you to type? Like, that one sentence probably took you 10 minutes. And then my wife actually is the one that came across Facebook, and she started telling us, hey, Facebook is something that you guys should get accounts with. And I remember Matt pushing back with my wife, basically saying like, nah, forget Facebook. It's all about MySpace. Because yeah, you can't bedazzle your Facebook account. And you can't. And my wife was adamant. She's like, no, guys, like, really, I think it's going to be Facebook, yada, yada, yada. And we always kind of joke about that because my wife had the foresight of it. So finally, I didn't get a Facebook account. I wasn't one of the first ones to the party at all. I was an observer. I was sitting back, kind of looking, thinking this is weird. Like, well, you know, do I really want to comment on your stuff? I graduated with you a couple years ago, but we don't talk anymore. And then what happened is I started to understand the importance of connection. And I'm not overly brilliant where I had said, oh, man, this is a great way to stay in front of your sphere of influence. And, you know, this is a great ROI to establish top of mind awareness. No, I didn't figure that part out at all. I just figured people were going there. So my wife was pushing me to get a Facebook account. So I literally told her, the words that came out of my mouth was, I said, if I'm going to get a Facebook account, I'm going to learn how to make money with this thing. And so I purposely put on my business hat to figure out how to monetize this Facebook thing. At the time, we were pushing a different product. The product, the company that we built previously, was an online website to be able to allow agents to showcase open houses on the internet. Mm-hmm. Now, before, your only another option was to pay money in a newspaper. So if I came to you and I said, John, how are you going to promote your open house? Oh, I'm going to pay in the newspaper. How much money are you going to pay? I'm going to pay a couple hundred bucks. Hey, I tell you what, pay me $50 a month and you can promote as many open houses as you want. And I'll promote our website within your local community. That's pretty cool, right?
That's awesome.
Ton of agents jumped on board right away. Well, I mean, we were killing it. Agents were jumping on board and our website was beautiful. I say that our website, in terms of its look and feel, was probably top five in the country. I think we were ahead of our time with the design. The problem is we were behind the eight ball when it came to the technology, because one day overnight, I realized that the multiple listing service had provided the data feeds to some of the big players like Trulia and Zillow, mm-hmm. Realtor.com. So now these companies were showcasing open houses. So that was a detriment to my business because the unique value proposition that I offered all of a sudden was now being supplemented for free, essentially for free. And so we were in a position where we were so into it money-wise that we had to figure out how in the hell do we sell this company, this product, this service. And so being that I was already had my mind on using Facebook, and at the time, we were creating video content as well. We basically, when I say we, our company, Matt, I, my wife, my sister-in-law, the four of us, we just started using social media to promote our business, which was selling a product which people didn't want to buy anymore, a product that actually was a bit obsolete. But hey, you got to sell what you have, right? So we're trying to push, we're trying to sell it. And then just little by little, people started inquiring, hey, you're using this Facebook thing. Can I use it for business? And then we had a unique call one day from somebody was at the CAR conference in San Diego. And they're like, hey, I just watched one of your videos right now. And I'm not interested in your service, but can I use video for my real estate business? And I thought, oh, my goodness, this is crazy. Somebody's in San Diego right now watching our video, watching a message that from me. Like, that just tripped me out.
Yeah.
That is just nuts. Like, I just thought that was crazy.